Hey everybody, welcome to Pit People, a turn-based strategy game created by the same folks who made Castle Crashers, so you're going to see the same type of humor and maybe even the same characters and some models here and there. Now, I played this a little bit at PAX East when I went over there, so I have a little bit of background knowledge of this game, but for now, we're going right into it. Curiously, there are no subtitles, so I'm going to try and stay quiet in these cinematics.
Transforming all we once knew into a colorful kaleidoscope of delicious chaos, and I love it. The world was more hospitable, no doubt, more orderly, more sensibly sickening because it sounded boring, and I hate being bored. I can't imagine a world without the bear or the storms, yes, the storms. Beautiful waves of emerald blood cry down from the heavens, promising death in lawless disarray, constantly upsetting the order. I get butterflies in my tummy just thinking about it. Yes. Yes! Speaking of which.
Alright, I'm gonna jump right into, Yep, okay, I remember
Let's
this one.
See. Oh, it's Horatio, the humble blueberry farmer, loving father, and the most boring creature on the face of this planet. But what's this? Looks like you've got a spicy situation on your hands, Well, it's been nice knowing you, Horatio. Not really. But now it's time for you to die. Yes, how exciting. Not for you, of course.
Alright, so it's basically up to Horatio and his wife to beat the shit out of all these peeps. Actually, for some reason, I'm not seeing the wife. Might be because, alright. I don't really remember, actually. There was a wife when I was playing the two-player co-op. By the way, this entire campaign could be played in a two-player co-op type thing. Alright, let me go ahead and change. Yeah, everything's fine here. I don't know why the cinematic was low. Maybe it's just like one of those things in display settings. Why the fuck would I have that? Crit mode. No idea. Okay, and let's go ahead and change to medium. Ah, there were subtitles, my bad. Show damage flags, nah. Sorry about that, I'll keep subtitles on for next time. Space? Ah, right. Okay, so how it works is that you pick a tile and then you just kind of move over to it by holding down the space button. Not by, you know, left clicking and then left clicking again. Then you move your characters along this hexagonal grid over here. Don't worry, Hansel. Daddy's coming. Now, all you gotta do is move right next to your enemy, and then afterwards your character will automatically attack. So there's no, like, need for movement and then attack. Does make things a little bit easier. I don't believe you. Horatio will never die. And as you can see, positioning does determine your target. So if you're in the middle of this glomp right over here, it's going to position. It's going to attack, I think, the closest enemy or something. And also depend on like cleave attacks and shit. Let's go ahead and move here. Actually, let me actually also go to no options, gameplay setting, execute meter speed, text speed. Yeah. Let's make things a little bit faster. Get fucked. Well, my son's fucking dead, so what's even the point? Oh, hell no, dude. I got no son. I just have blueberries. Child eater. Different weapons have different attributes to them, so some people, they can be positioned two tiles away from an opponent, and then they just, like, throw axes, or they fire their bow, or all this other shit.
With no
nothing but a handful of blueberries and a stupid look on his face, Horatio set out to find some shelter, burdened with the realization that none of this would have happened had he listened. And to make matters worse, he's got weak arms and he's not all that handsome. I don't see what all the fuss is about. But all of this will haunt him until I decide to end his misery. What fun.
He has a mustache. How can he not be handsome? Is he not feeling grief for his kid? He's just like, oh, fuck it, who cares? I'll just have a new one. It's way different than the co-op demo I played with in PAX East. Maybe that's because they didn't want to give too much of the story. Or maybe my memory's just shit. Oh, I think this is our first party member.
A beautiful lady. She looked hungry. Horatio shared his blueberries. Now, you shared your berries. Huh. How generous of you. Her name was Pipistrella, and though she looked more than capable, she requested Horatio's aid. You see, her castle was raided by grumpy warriors, and she doesn't like that very much. Go on, my little hero. Perhaps this could become a mutually beneficial relationship.
Alright. Let's just get right into it. I could skip the videos if I want to, but nah. Is that her dad just taking on the armies of hell?
Oh, the one with the mustache told me you guys are stupid and weak. I don't know why he'd say that.
Okay, even though it looks like there's overwhelming odds, we're gonna do just fine. Oh. That thing is huge. Okay, swords are weak against helmets. Now let's get bonus damage against helmets. Okay. Oh. Alright, well I'm still gonna move Horatio because why wouldn't I? It's not gonna do anything else. Also I can block off this area. Oh, now I can. Maybe I should use Horatio as a meat shield? Just tank up all those arrow shots? I need to get to the left side, I know that much actually. So we're just gonna have to just take it. Yeah, she's a little bit exposed here. Don't worry, it's not old medieval. There's like guns and a bunch of other stupid shit in this game. It's kind of wonderful, actually. Let's go. Away from the arrows. Oh, he still can get us? I didn't know that. We actually have no range damage, so we've got to hold the line. Well, they're inaccurate because it's long range. Wow, they ended up killing one of their own. This reminds me of, like, Lord of the Rings Third Age, like, turn-based strategy game. That was quite a meme arena of a game.
Gentlemen, go wreak havoc elsewhere. Sorry, Pip. Are you upset?
Okay. Well, that happened. Yeah, if you enjoy the humor of Castle Crashers, you'll be right at home here. Granted, I don't know how...
With her castle in ruins and a very dead daddy, Pipistrella accompanies Captain Worthless. And what a woman. Her optimistic outlook and reckless bravery captivated Horatio. So much, in fact, that he immediately forgot about his son and his home and... Yes, you did.
How did you win, yeah? Where
I see. Horatio gave Pipistrella the remainder of his blueberries, and they headed for the city. The perfect place to recuperate and make plans for Horatio's inevitable failure and death. Plus, there's a pretty good restaurant there that has great beef stew and cornbread.
I want to go to Zombie Island. Aw. I guess my Scooby-Doo tail will kind of wait up. There's Candy Island over there. Alright, let's keep moving. I think we get like a van or something at some point. That should be interesting. And there's the city right over there with a bendy straw that goes up to the sky. Alright, let's go.
Yes, the city. How it bustles with excitement.
Alright. So, there's different stores that can do, like, different things. Like, for example, this is the pit where we can, I think, like, fight other people. And then over here, I think this is, like, a mercenary store. This is how you play online. Okay. Market. Alright. Insane difficulty. Yeah, probably not. And a music player. Alright. Like how the city bustles. Boom, boom, boom. Gotta go through security. Alright. Let's go in. And here we could do some PvP. Here's the Cyclops, Axe Thrower that I kind of like picked out in our PAX East demo. Actually, I'd love to have him join about. Yeah, I don't know what I'm looking at. They really added in a bunch more cinematics, actually. If you're on acid, this game is great. Alright, so let's see. One helmet, so she's going to have to just deal with that guy. I definitely will, buddy. Yeah, if your kind of character is put in front of another character, it can sort of tank damage and stuff, which is great. Take that, take that. Deal with my shield of fortune. Alright, I think this is actually a good spot. Oh, actually, I can move her here. Sometimes you can actually capture, new party members by capturing them in the wild and stuff with, like, a net. Yep. No, he's joking! Save the giraffe! Yeah, there's the guy with the Uzi, so that's gonna be quite a meme. I'm gonna have to use the shield in order to block his fire. Yeah, Horatio's gonna have to tank most of this, actually. Here, I just want the whole squad here right now. Oh, my Cyclops, man. Be careful. Here, let's do this. There we go. Oh, she's so close to dying. Okay, he's gonna obviously run back, but he can't fight any other way. I think characters level up? I'm pretty sure characters level up in this game. It's like a hallmark of turn-based strategy games. Like this. Alright, get in here. There you go, there's some axes. Double fucking kill, god bless. Look how he has a crocodile helmet. Oh, I should move Horatio. Whatever. Fuck it. We did it. Got some MVPs right over there. Ooh, time to get the gold.
They had won the battle. Horatio kissed Joseph on the lips and then stabbed him in the stomach. Now,
A hero is stronger and has more health. Let's see. This one? Yeah, I want Horatio. Since you play Castle Crashers, you deserve some more. Oh, wow. Good meme, actually. Look at a house. Oh, damn. First, can I look at my... Oh, I don't think I can look at my gear. I'll have to just go into the house. Ah, and there's the player 2 setup. Okay. So now here I can like customize my items and stuff. Going to give Horatio, give him Horatio's stomach, or I can make him bald. Change his weapon up a little bit. Paperweight. Oh, I see. He gets to throw fucking bricks. Alright. Alright, well I don't want that actually. I just want him to get the box cutter with a good old fashioned farm fence. Actually, what's the better shield? More dodge capability, but a lot more block here, so why would I ever get that? Alright, you, what's up? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, buddy. There we go. Let's see these paperweight thing. Are they better? Or is this just like a cosmetic upgrade, actually? Might be a cosmetic upgrade. Yeah, it doesn't look like it's any different. It's like weight, damage, range, defense, block, dodge. But like, I'm not getting any change. Fuck it, yeah. Oh, good. Get the fuck out of here. Alright, now we can move our wagon with cannons. We go whoosh super fast. I think we also have like, yeah, we have some ammo here or there. Or actually, I don't know what this thing does. This like meter is. Alright, where to go? Okay, there's some bullies there. Let me search around a little bit more. There's a, what the fuck is that thing? Is that the bear that crash landed? Yeah, I'm just sort of thinking like, is he using the bear that just like crashed onto the planet in order to move about the shuttle and all that other shit? I guess we're fighting the narrator. Aww. Can't do that. Oh, okay. Yeah, I guess he can do that. Into the ocean he goes. No, please. Alright, let's go here, let's go there, and we can move her on the flanks. Alright, so the helmet guys are the guys with the fish heads right there, not the helmet. I mean, not the hood. Bring it. I don't know what this is all about. Does he have a helmet? Is that the symbol for helmet? I guess it is, actually. Yeah, it is. Okay. So we're gonna need to change you up for... Shit, all these guys have helmets, except for that hooded guy. How about we move you here? Oh, I know what I'm gonna do, actually. Well, the Axeman, like... What does it do? It, like, stuns them, so that's good. Oh, I should have actually moved him here. Fuck it. I want to burst down this guy as much as possible. Wait, Cyclops powers? What? I don't know how these Cyclops powers are done. Wait, no, that's not what I wanted. Oh, fuck it. Oh, Pipistrella. How does one do these Cyclops powers again? Hold on. play fights. Right. How about survival guide? Oh, survival guide is F1. That's not working. How about we just do that? Okay, got a stun here. That's good. Probably shouldn't have skipped that. There we go. There's a level up right there. You're slowed. You know what? No. Ah, shit, she's slowed. Alright. Keep him right here. Move him. There we go. Keep throwing bricks, man! Oh, got him. Nice. Get stunned. Oh, no. Like, I really shouldn't have skipped that prompt, actually. It's not like a fusion thing, is it? Let me check. Alright, it's not a fusion thing. I think it's just a level up system, honestly. Do I remember something about Cyclops powers like... Oh fuck, I guess I'll figure it out when I look back at the recording. Oh. I'm gonna steal your ride, dude. Why? You fool! I remember her. She's like super waifu actually. Back in my demo game actually. Alright, so she joins us, good shit. I'm gonna have to take out these Castle Crasher masks actually. Okay, quest done, that's good. And let me see, let's go back to town really quick and then we'll end this off. First part. Yeah, that's actually what we have to do. We have to capture that guy. Oh, and there's actually the bear. Okay, well, I'll see you guys next time for the second part. Bye-bye.